One of the most fun cars we've driven for this price. Listen to that. I feel like I went back in time, like 20 years. Yeah, 7.5. What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we've got a really cool car for our affordable fun car segment. And it's also a viewer's car. This is Alexander's Renault Clio RS, and it is a Clio 2 from 2001. So it's also a phase 2. And today, well, we're going to show you around it. We're going to show you all the modifications that Alexander has made and all the stuff that he has added. And after that, we'll take it for a drive towards the Autobahn for an Autobahn blast. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to receive updates when we upload a new video. And check us out on Instagram if you like, at Autotop.nl, for some behind the scenes footage. So, let's take a look at this car. The Clio 2 had a facelift in 1999. This is a 2001 car, so it's a phase 2. And you can see that because we have different headlights than a phase 1, these triangular headlights. We have a different grille as well. This is a modification. We've got Autech Wizard wheels. They look really, really cool on this car. 16-inch with Michelin Pilot Sport 3 tires on there, which is a really nice tire. You can see the 2-liter 16 valve badge right there. And I have to say, it looks really cool on these wheels. It's very cute and sporty at the same time. As you can see, we also have a different exhaust. So this is a K-Tech Super Sport exhaust without a center silencer. It's got a great sound, and well, we'll check out the engine as well. Because we've got a naturally aspirated 2-liter 16 valve engine with 172 horsepower and 200 newton meters of torque, with a JR open air filter to get that really nice induction sound. And you can really hear that when you drive the car. This might be one of the most fun and cool, funky little cars we've driven on our channel for this price. I mean, if you look at Fun for Euro, it's an amazing car, because Alexander actually paid 3,500 euros for this car, then started modifying it a bit for, you know, a better driving experience. He also has Eibach springs that are 30 millimeters lower. But it's just a really cool, fun little car. It weighs 1,010 kilos dry. I mean, that's super light. And you've got 172 horsepower. That's a really nice combo. The Clio RS also got these Renault Sport seats. Nice and sporty, but really small. Like, it's got a very short lower part. And I mean, my back ends like here, and the seat does ends here. So these are French seats, as we would call them. So on the interior, I'll start it up so I can show you guys the steering wheel. We've got a beautifully recovered steering wheel, really nice soft leather, perforated on the sides and with a blue stitching in there, and a 12 o'clock marker. Super nice. Alexander also redid these sun visors, and the entire roof lining has been done as well. So it does look kind of fresh up here. It's really nice. The facelift, the phase 2, also had this all redone. So this was much more modern for that era. And it's done 224,500 kilometers. I mean, it's actually in great condition for that mileage. So it's been taken care of quite well, actually, because it feels really nice. Now, we've got a 5-speed manual gearbox, which is really like loose. And when you first get into it, you have to like guess where the gears are. That's first. it's like super flimsy, but it actually works quite well if you get used to it. Now, we also have a rev counter, as you can see, which has the red line at 6,750 RPM, as you can see right there. But it actually goes way further, like up almost 7,500 RPM. And apparently they fixed that in the phase 3, because they were like, oh, that's not right. They probably just thought, oh, okay, well, we'll fix that in the next one. Okay. So let's take it for a little drive. You can immediately hear that induction sound is super nice, and oh, the thing weighs absolutely nothing. Listen to that. That was just about the red light, so I think it's between 70-250 RPM and 7.5. But listen to that. I mean, that is a really, really great sound. And the combination of a very light car with a naturally aspirated engine that revs quite high is always a good combination, because you don't need that much power to go fast in a car like this, or to feel like you're going fast in a car like this, because even though the car is actually quite quick for today's standards, it's supposed to do 7.1 seconds from 0 to 100 kilometers an hour and has a top speed of 220. I mean, that's not bad, but it's not super quick either. But you, when you drive it, it actually feels much quicker because it's so light, and you have that great induction sound. You've got a little bit of a rumble from the exhaust, and I mean, you just throw it into a corner and you just feel that it weighs nothing. Oh, what a great little car. This is actually a really, really good car. Here we go through the tunnel. Now, Alexander emailed us because he said you've done quite a few Renault Sport models, but you've never done this one, and I think you'll like it. Well, you were absolutely right, man. This is a really, really fun little car. Can I heel and toe? No. My knee would probably hit the steering wheel. Ooh. Oh man, this is actually really nice, and I love the like old school tuning of it as well. You've got, you know, an open air filter, a different exhaust, a suspension kit, and you've got this great sounding, great handling little car. It's just super fun. When they upgraded this car to the phase 3, so another facelift, you got 182 horsepower, so 10 horsepower extra. And they also changed the exhaust. They actually just went into the spare wheel storage to get that exhaust in there, and then they just got rid of the spare wheel. But listen to this. That sounds awesome. So let's see, 220 kilometers an hour top speed. Let's see if we can get close to that. We're in fifth gear right now, which is top gear. And I have to say, we're at 210 right now. It's not bad, actually, the stability and stuff like that. It's actually not bad. But anyway, that's not what this car is about. So we're going to brake. Well, we had to brake anyway, but hello. Thank you. Here we go. Third gear. Yeah, 7.5 almost, I think. Or 7250. Couldn't see it that time. But man. Yeah, 7250. They just don't make cars like this anymore. And I think if they would be able to do it like this, just cut down that weight on these hot hatches, that would make them so much better. I mean, 172 horsepower it's literally nothing now. Everything has well over 200 horsepower. But this is just so good to drive because it's so light. I mean, I know that with all the safety stuff, it's really difficult to get a car weighing this with a modern standard, but oh, what a cool car. I think this might actually be the cheapest car we've ever done, but it is a lot of fun. The suspension is really good as well. It's actually, it's very composed for such a small, light little car. It's actually quite impressive, which I wasn't really expecting. Let's throw it into this corner. Oh, that's really good. Of course, we don't have a limited slip diff, but as long as you don't push it too hard, you don't really need it. I mean, you don't have that much power, so. Oh, it's a beautiful day, 20 something degrees out. Driving a nice little hot hatch. I feel like I went back in time, like 20 years. Oh, it's 24 degrees and it's the 31st of March. That's actually, it's quite hot. Okay, anyway, enough with the weather. Okay, here we go. Little tire squeal. Oh, get in there, little Clio RS. It's so good because if you have a heavy car with a lot of power, you're fast as well. But the thing with a light car with a little less power is that it's so much more controllable and you can actually explore the limits of the car, while with all these much more powerful cars, it's hard to get to the limit on the public roads because you have to, you know, you'd be doing quite a significant speed. And with this one, you're just not. It's quite safe for your license as well because you can absolutely floor it almost everywhere and you'd be pretty safe with your license. So that is awesome. Thank you so much, Alexander, for bringing it to us. I really enjoyed driving your car.
Which way is it?
Right. To you guys, thanks so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. We've been doing these more affordable cars lately. I hope you enjoy it. Let me know in the comments and I'll see you at the next video. If you want to check out another video, you can go and watch this video or go and check out this playlist of reviews. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you at the next one. Bye.